Well, would you put your hands together and let's give God praise on this Sunday morning. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Come on and open up your mouth and give God praise. It's a beautiful day. It's a wonderful day to lift him up. Come on, let's give him glory. Let's give him the praise that's due his name. The scripture says, oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. How many came to glorify our King? How many came to give him praise? Come on and tell him, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for this day. For this is the day that the Lord has made. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, I came to do my part. I came to shout hallelujah. I came to say thank you, Jesus. I came to clap my hands. I came to lift him up. Because he said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. Oh, magnify the Lord. Come on, let's make him big. In the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, get a praise on your lips. Stir it up. Those in the cyber sanctuary, come on and bless them in your house. Bless them in your kitchen. Bless them in your room. He deserves your worship. I said he deserves your worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's look to the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we honor you on today. We magnify your holy name. We thank you because of who you are. We thank you that you gave your son, oh God, that we might have salvation. Father, we pray now in the name of Jesus that you would have your way in the midst of this service. Oh God, have free reign today. Have your way in the name of Jesus. Move by your power. Let your glory be revealed. Manifest yourself in this service. Oh Father, hear the cry of your people. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. Father, we lift our pastor up to you tonight. Anoint him now in the name of Jesus. Give him a word for right now, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that will change lives forever. Have your way, oh God. Heal in the midst of this service. Set free in the midst of this service. Deliver in the name of Jesus. Deliver in this service, oh God. We lift up every mother before you right now. We give you honor and we give you glory. We thank you for this day that we celebrate mothers today. Father, we lift you up now and just ask that you would bless them right now in the name of Jesus. Touch their bodies. Father, as we celebrate mothers, we thank you for our mothers, oh God. We thank you for the love. We thank you for choosing our mothers. Just for us, we thank you. And we celebrate you for them. We give you glory in the name of Jesus. And Father, we lift up those. We lift up those whose mothers has gone on to be with the Lord. Father, we haven't forgot about them. Father, we ask that you would strengthen them throughout this day. Encourage their hearts. Lift them up, oh God. Lift up their heads. Cause them to remember the joy and the love of their mothers. And we give you all of the glory in Jesus' name. Would you bless him? Would you give him some praise? Would you tell him thank you? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for my mother. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for your glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, hey, come on and bless him. Come on and bless him. Hallelujah. Come on, stir it up. Stir it up. Dig down deep. Give him glory. This is the day that the Lord has made. Come on, Zion. Come on, Zion. Lift him up. Let him hear you in the cyber sanctuary. Those in the cyber sanctuary, let them hear you in the next room. Come on and praise our King in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 I know it's Mother's Day, but I came to praise God today. Woo! I feel him early this morning. I came to tell him thank you for your goodness. Tell him thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your kindness. Hallelujah. Thank you. you because you've been so good. Said thank you because you've been so good. You woke me up this morning. You didn't have to do it, but you did. That's why we gotta praise. I want to welcome everyone that's watching on Facebook and YouTube and those here at Perfecting Church to our 10:45 service. Let's give God praise. Oh, it's going to be a wonderful Sunday. The presence of the Lord is here. He's here. I'm going to ask for those of you who are at home watching in the Cyber Sanctuary, if you would just hit the share button, because today is a very special day. Today is Mother's Day, so hit that share button. Your mother may live out of town. Hit that share button and tell Mama, tune in to Perfecting Church, because we're celebrating mothers on today. Amen. We want to say happy Mother's Day to all of the mothers. Come on and put your hands and give God praise for all of the mothers, all of the mothers. As a matter of fact, I want the cameras to see all of the beautiful mothers that are here with us today. Let's all give God praise for all of the mothers. Come on, mothers, wave your hands. Hallelujah, yes. Hallelujah, we praise God. Oh, come on, we can do better than that. Let's give God praise for all of them. You look so beautiful. You look so beautiful. Lord, we thank you for our mother. Don't they look beautiful? Amen. Hallelujah. Well, how many are ready to worship God on today? You feel his presence. You feel him moving. Well, I'm so happy to say that the mass choir is behind me, and they're ready to lift him up, and they're ready to give him glory. Would you put your hands together and give God praise for the mass choir? Mass choir.
Oh, come on, get up on your feet. We need somebody who want to call on the name of Jesus. Everybody, get up. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to the mountain. I'm talking to the saints that love to call the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus. Hallelujah. You can't call that name too many names here too many times because he'll show up. Hallelujah. I love to call him. I said, I love to call him. Sometimes I call him late in the midnight hour. I call him early in the morning. I call him in the noonday. Praise everybody. Hallelujah. We wish all the mothers a very happy Mother's Day. And we have lots of good treats for the moms that are in service with us on today. And for those who are watching in the cyber sanctuary, add your mom's name in the comments and tell us something special about her. She may be gone, but she's never forgotten. So tell us about your mother. For those of you who are watching in the cyber sanctuary, tell us something about your wonderful mother. Let's give God praise one more time for all the wonderful mothers that we wish a happy Mother's Day. Well, it's indeed an honor and a privilege to present to some and introduce to others. He's the pastor and founder of Perfecting Church, Bishop-elect Marvin L. Winans.
Come on, let's say amen. God praise. Calling the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You in E flat? Yeah, let me sing my song. Worthy is the name Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Now, if you weren't here Tuesday night, you missed a move in a moment. Lift those hands. And just say that one time. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise.
Worthy is your name.
Come on, sing, sing.
Worthy is your name.
Say it one more time. Worthy,
worthy is your name.
You God bless you. I promise you, ever since Tuesday, I've been singing it every day. Lord, have mercy. The name of the Lord is excellent. The name of the Lord is worthy. Come on, come on, saints. Give them the praise that he's due. I got to move on. Seated in the presence of the Lord. There is a name I love to hear. I love to sing its words. Sound like music in my ear. It's the sweetest name on earth. If you say it loud, there's music playing. Say it soft, it's just like praying. The name. With that right there. I want to take the time to wish all of our mothers a very blessed and happy Mother's Day. It is biblical for us to honor our mothers. I just want every mother, I think this is what Elder Healy was trying to do, I just want every mother to stand. If you're here and you're a mother, I want you to stand. And now, camera, would you pick up all these beautiful hats and beautiful women that are here and those in the choir? Come on and give God praise. Come on, gentlemen, open your mouth, scream, holler. Yes, sir. honor you today. We honor you today. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We honor you today. And we have some of the leadership of the men's department. Come on, Brother Reggie, Brother Hunt, Brother Glass. And we have gifts for all the mothers. So I'm going to ask that our ministers, male ministers, come and grab the basket. And I guess it's better if they stand up. I'm sorry, I set y'all down too quick. All of our mothers in the balcony, on the main floor, would you stand one more time? And they're going to give you a gift. And when you receive your gift, you may be seated.
Praise God for our mothers, amen. As you all are being served, once you receive your gift, you may be seated. All right, we want to do some special recognition for a few of our mothers on today. Please, as you receive your gift, please be seated so we can see who we need to serve, amen. So at this time, we want to recognize our newest mother. If you have just had a child within the last 6 months, stand up and raise your hand so I can see you. You got one back there, I see. All right. Any other that's here within 6 months? Help me out, everybody, because the lights is kind of loud. All right, so if this is our only mother, you see one? All right, now if you had a child within the past 3 months, I see one and I see another one. I see someone pointing in the middle over there. So I'm trying to break it down to the lowest to newest. So if you 3 months, please can stand in. 3 months. 3 months is it? Is that the winner? Okay. I see your hand. You had 3 months too? What's the birthday? 3 weeks. Well, praise God. All right, anybody been 3 weeks? If you haven't had it in 3 weeks, sit down, please. All right. Well, praise God for 3 weeks and you here. Amen. Just came to church. Happy Mother's Day. And so let's see who is our eldest mother in the building. If you are above 85 and you're in the building, please stand. All right, no one over 80. Oh, there's one mother, 85. Over 85. Amen. Mother Riley? Okay, if you're over 90, hold on. Now, if you're over 90, please stand. Mother Riley, you over 90? You over 90? Anybody that's over 90? All right. Okay. So how old are you, Mother Riley? 85? 88. Amen. 89 in the back? All right, well, we got it in the back. Amen. Praise God. 89 over here. All right, we got 89 on the side and the 90. What month? What birthday month? October? February. So she'll be almost 90 coming up. She'll be 90 in October. All right, well, we got it over here on to the right. Amen. To the right. She'll be 90 in October, so she turned 89 in October. Right. She just turned 89. She's going to be 90 this year. I don't know, am I wrong? I think, thank you. I didn't know if I was wrong or right. Praise God. All right. Mother with the most children. If you have above 10 children, please stand. 10. There we go. I know Sister White back there. Anybody got more than 10 children? Well, praise God. Our annual mother, Mother White. Oh, we got 10? Huh? What you got? Okay. Do we got 11? Okay. Huh? Why, she up there standing, we said she had 10. She don't have 10. How many you have? I said 10 and she's standing, so I'm sorry. Okay, so we got 10 down here. Praise God, everybody. 10, 11. Sister White doesn't have 10. Okay, so we got 10 right here. Praise God. Sister Buford. Amen. Huh? It is rough. But this is Mother's Day. It ain't about me. Praise God for our mothers. All right. And Mother Fridge, we want to bless you on today for being our church mother. Bless you, Mother Fridge. She's over our mother's department. Praise God for Mother Fridge. It's over the mother's department at the church. Praise God. I think I'm done. And at this time, I want to turn the furthest of the service back to Bishop Winans.
Thank you. It's not easy.
All right, that's okay. All right, all right.
I also want to announce that we have a gift for all of the PC Mothers Board. If you're on the Mothers Board, would you please stand? All of our mothers that comprise the Mothers Board that Mother Fridge is over. Let's give God praise for all of our church mothers. Amen. There is a gift for all of you. And this is what it is. It's a beautifully made pillow. It's handmade. And at the end of the service, they're going to bring it to you. So do not leave without your beautifully handmade pillow that we have just for all of our church mothers. Let's give God praise for them. Y'all can come back. Yeah. What we're going to do right now is we're going to have a My Mom contest. And we want to invite just 10. So if you're gonna come, come and you're going to tell us the reason why you think your mother is the best mother in the entire world. So I need no more than 10 to come quickly if your mother is here. If your mother is here, bring your mother with you so we can see this beautiful mother. Oh, Lord, that's red. That ain't red. I'm trying. That's the other girl. All right. Excellent. Come on. We need. That's one. We got two. All right. Well, bring your mama. You got to bring your mama. Go get your mama. All right. This is wonderful. We'll wait for you in the balcony if your mother's here. Oh. She said, I know. This is great. All right. One, two, three, four. Y'all come on down. Sister, what? Come on down. Your kids got to bring. Where are your kids? They coming? Huh? Oh, you bringing your mom. I got it. There she goes. She's coming now. All right, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. You bringing your mama? How many we got? We got one more. All right, we got 10 right now? All right. All right. Okay. All right, take the mic now. Now, you're going to tell us why you think your mother is the best mother in all of the world. You got about, do we have 10 or we got 11? Hold on, somebody snuck in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12. They just can't count. They we just can't. Who's, I don't know. Who's? Who? Well, just tell us anyway. I know. It's somebody gonna, not going to get a gift, but we want to hear about your mama. I told y'all 10. Tell us your name and your mom's name and why you think she's the best in the world.
My name is Deanna. My mother's name is Mary. She's the best mom.
What is? Turn around this way. Turn around this way. There we go.
She's strong. She's independent. She's always been there. It's a lot of things. She can get her shirt off her back. She just, she's my everything. So.
Amen. That's all right. Good. Good.
Praise the Lord. My first day at college, a professor said, "What's your name?" I said, "Believe." "You sleep in church every day?" "No, because this beautiful young mother here gave birth to me. In those days of high infant mortality in Africa, she did 12 biological and 9 made it alive."
Wow. Wow.
"First 8 were all boys straight." "So why she's a good mother? They were religious, they were not saved, just religious. They stand on the back of a semi and they go for their Jehovah's Witnesses convention then. She didn't know God, but she professed to know God. They stand for hours. They go for a trip for 5-6 hours and they come back standing on the back of a semi. She was pregnant. She was told not to go. She said, I will go. I believe God. As soon as she came back, 3 hours later, her water broke and they gave birth to me. So I told you this child is Believe. I would name him Believe. And I grew up believing God
a minister of the gospel. What a mother. Thank God.
My name is Josiah, and the reason why my mom is the best is because she takes care of me, she helps me, and she gives us what we want if we're good.
How you doing? My name is Anthony Watson. My mother is Loretta Watson, if you all may know. She's the best mom because she raised me to be a man of God. She raised me to be a man in general. She kept me in the church. She kept me out of trouble, made sure I always did good. Even when I was going astray, she always kept me on the right path. She's really my best friend. I feel like I can tell her anything, you know. She really has a great personality that you all know. So for her to be my mom, I know I take so many characteristics from her. And she's just such a hard worker and such a go-getter. I want to embody that and do everything that she does for me and just for her in return. So she is like the best mother ever, just because she always come through even when I don't expect it. And just she's always there for me.
So my name is Joy and my mom's name is Felicia. I think that my mom is the best mom because all of those children that you see, she has kept them all from day one. She has been our support. She labors tirelessly for us. Everything that she has, she's up late trying to figure out where to find the best daycare or find the best schools for the kids. And every dime, every dollar, every tear, every prayer is all about her family. She has been my rock. Like, everything, y'all, from putting on my wedding, cooking food for hundreds of people, to supporting me when I graduated from college. I was the only child. And here we have all of this legacy, and she was right there every step of the way, and she never doubted me. She always supported me in everything that I do. She is the most selfless person I have ever met. And if I can be half the woman she is, y'all, I would be better for it. God is good to us. This is our rock. She's been through physical challenges. She still thinks about us. She's been through surgery after surgery, and it's still all about family. She does not put herself in any position to take the credit. All glory belongs to God. She is definitely a woman to be praised and admired, and I'm glad she's mine.
Praise the Lord, thanks. My name is Kenyatta Campbell, and my mom is Minister Maria Peoples.
What you say?
And my mom is the best mom in the whole wide world. As you all know, she's been a perfecting for many years, and she has been able to not only give to our family and make sure that our family is blessed, she has led by example. She's shown us as women of God how to be pleasant, how to be kind, how to be given, and how to make sure that you're giving back to your community. So, Mom, you are the best mom in the world. I thank you, and I love you.
You ready? All right, there you go.
In my opinion, to me, I'm not saying she's the best mom, but to me, she is the best mom.
Right.
Because she's like my mom and my dad, because my dad wasn't always there. But she inspired me to be strong, because I'm serious, like literally. She carried two of these two in the daycare by herself. And before I was in like another, me and my family, we were in a whole nother state. And my mom, she said we were moving. I did not want to move. I wanted to stay home. But when we finally got there, I was like, I don't know, Mom. I don't think so. But she kept on persevering, going forward, praising the Lord. And this is the best mom in my opinion. And the only mom there could be.
The reason why I think my mom is the best mom. The reason why I think my mom is the best mom, she She's caring, she's kind, she's smart, she's brave, and we're thankful that she's with us.
Amen.
I'm Christian Mullins. We had some hard times, but we never left each other, and God has never left us. Whew. We had some hard times, and that's the main thing, that God has never forsaken us. I always keep coming back to the church because she instilled that in me. It didn't matter if she couldn't do it. She had somebody else to do it. She put somebody else in charge over me to do it, whether it was an elder or somebody. And I appreciate that, Mom. You didn't have to be the best mom. You didn't have to do everything that's right, but you did right by me, and I appreciate that.
My mom is the best mom because when I was younger in her belly, the doctors told my mom to abort me because she had mental health problems, but she didn't abort me because she loved me so much, and I'm really glad for that.
I love my mom so much because she was there for me. And when I came in this world, she taught me how to sing. And God gave me a gift. But my mom, she helped me get me that gift. So that's how I know how to sing.
Amen. To understand what it means to be the best mom is to realize the emphasis that my mother put on all 10 of her children having the Holy Ghost at a young age. And I'm here to stand today that 7 of us still have the Holy Ghost on today. It is also to understand that she tells us the story of how the Lord slew her on the floor in front of the altar and said that kings and priests shall reign out of her loins. Therefore, her children are leaders in many aspects of the world today. It is to understand that Bishop teaches us the book of Proverbs, but we must understand that my mother taught us the book of Proverbs every morning. It was our alarm clock. She taught us that she was wisdom and not to let her go. And it was to teach her, keep her, for she was your life. And it was also to understand that when you got up to sing, you didn't get up and sing all Millie Mouse. You got up to sing, and when you stood up to sing, you stood up and you sung with the spirit and the understanding also. And she said, when you quote a scripture, you don't just get up there and quote like this. You say where it's found, and you say, Psalms 34 says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? Who is this King? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. That's why I think Mother Buford
who I am named after is the best mother.
Amen.
All right, up. All right, so here's how we're gonna do this. No, be real quick though. Happy Mother's Day to my mother. She is the best too, but I don't want a prize. All right, so here's how we're gonna do it, Perfecting. When Brother Glass, raise your hand, Brother Glass, when he puts his arm over the mother, by round of applause, let's give an applause for that mother who you think won, although we bless all of you mothers. And then the loudest applause will be the winner. So you all want to practice really loud real quick before we get there? So everybody clap real loud, real quick. All right. So Brother Glass is going to start right here. All right. Brother Belief. Young man right here. Right. Brother Watson. Mr. White. All right. Well, it sounds like to me that was her. You know, it's kind of hard with the Bufords because there's so many of them, and it's just, you know, I don't know. But let's just try this. So am I right if I say right here? No. What about right here? Right here? Right here? Right here? Right here? That sounds like our winner, this young man. All right, let's, the grand prize. He gets the grand prize. All right, that's the grand prize right there. Everybody else, everyone gets a gift though. If all mothers can wait, and each one of you will get a gift. Yes, ma'am.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That was absolutely wonderful. Just to hear those children. Hallelujah. Well, let's say amen as our choir comes back at this time. Let's receive them by saying amen.
Father, it is the entrance of thy word that bringeth light and life, and we pray that the glorious light of the gospel of Jesus Christ would shine bright. As always, may the people be blessed by thee and never impressed by me. Cause through the revelation of thy word, these thy people see you more clearly, love you more dearly, follow you more nearly. And now, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And every glad heart said amen. Amen. Come on and put those hands together and give God praise like he deserves it. Come on, come on. Come on. God is great, and he is greatly to be praised. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. This is a very special day, and I don't want to keep you long. I certainly have been touched to hear this is a generation that it's all about them. And so to take the time to discuss and to share with your parents how you feel about them and how important your mother is to you. I enjoy it. He said, whatever we want, she gives it to us. And that's just the attribute of a mother, isn't it? Yeah, she wants her children to be happy and to be satisfied. And it is so important that we raise a generation. The Bible says that we are to give honor to our mother, and we're not to forget her when she is old. And it's so important for us to recognize that we live in a selfie generation, that people are really putting the needs of themselves over anybody else's. I don't hear nobody talking to me. And the sense of community, the sense of giving when you are not involved in the receiving. You see, a lot of folk want to do when it involves them. They don't mind helping when they're going to get something. But when we give because we're being selfless, that's what they, one of the children said, this is the most selfless, I believe it was Minister Peoples. It's so important that we take time and just encourage one another. And the one that said that the doctors told her to abort, that's precious. It is so important that we understand that it is now, people are fighting, get this now, they're fighting for the right to kill babies. It is now considered health care to kill unborn children. Y'all might as well talk back to me, because I ain't changing. I'm not worried about being popular. We got to be correct. Hallelujah. And I'm not trying to make anyone feel bad. But when we look at a Mother Buford that had 10 children, and Belief's mother, Imada Merrill, to have 8 boys straight, Lord have mercy. And I certainly want to give honor to my mother. Sometimes I forget, because she's with me all the time, that I forget that she has other children. And so that's where she is today. She is in Nashville with the mother folks. But praise God, she is coming home. But to have children, it's the reason we celebrate Joy White, to have children and to understand that the Bible says that the children are the reward of the Lord. They are His heritage. And so we praise God, and again, we salute all of you mothers today. Let's give God praise for all of our mothers. And to Mother Young, they just came down a little late, but we praise God for Mother Young. And You know, I like to eat, so Mother Young holds a special place in my heart. What y'all didn't know is that they had Young's Restaurant over there on East State Fair. And every Tuesday after the fast, we would break it in that restaurant. And it was everything you wanted. And please don't let her fry some chicken or some barbecue ribs or something. You know, it was a wonderful situation. And so she tells me she doesn't cook anymore now, but y'all missed it. But I can truly testify, and we praise God for her being a mother here. And she's here. And I like when she brings a tambourine. All right, grab your Bibles, if you will, and turn with me. I promise you, I'm not going to preach long. I'm just going to make an observation. As we did this morning, the 19th chapter of the book of St. John, the 25th through the 27th verse. If you don't mind standing for the reading of God's word, I know you got comfortable when I set you down that time, but in deference to the word of God. If you have the gospel according to St. John, the 19th chapter beginning at the 25th verse, indicate by shouting, "I got it." Hear the beginning of the reading of God's word. "Now there stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by whom he loved, he saith unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour that disciple took her unto his own home." So far the text. Would you look at your neighbor, repeat our subject, say, neighbor, thank God for the mother. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Just a couple of observations, and we'll let you go to your brunch. Some of y'all getting nervous. I made it 1 o'clock. I just knew he was going to be. This seems as if it is the most inopportune, inconvenient time to have a Mother's Day celebration. Some things we need to note. Jesus is now on the cross. He is hanging there with spikes in his hands, nails in his feet, a spear in his side. He's dying. He's in the throes of crucifixion. And he stops dying and looks at, as the writer says, his mother. Now, you can search the scriptures. You can search all of the synoptics. You will never find a quote in the Bible where Jesus ever addressed Mary as mother. I'm not saying he didn't. I'm just saying it ain't in the text. Jesus never calls her mother. It's an understandable observation simply because you have religious offshoots that makes her the queen or the mother of God. Hallelujah. Mary was between the age of 13 and 15 years old when she became pregnant. She was a virgin before giving birth and after giving birth. Thank you, somebody, because that's a miracle. This is not to be confused with the Immaculate Conception, because the Immaculate Conception says that Mary was born without sin. That's completely incorrect. I know I'm stepping on some toes here, but Mary was the vessel that was chosen by God. But let us not forget that Mary had to say yes. And when Gabriel, Lord have mercy, announced to Mary that she would conceive a child, he not only told her that she would have a child, but at that moment gave a gender reveal and said, you're going to have a son. If that wasn't enough, the angel told Mary what she would name him. And his name shall be called Jesus. And not only that, but he told what his life would entail. That he would save his people from his sins. Mary said, that's good. I don't mean to holler at you. I'm just trying to put it in fast forward. Mary said, that's nice. But how can these things be, seeing that I have never known a man? And the angel said, the Holy Ghost is going to overshadow you. And when the Holy Ghost gets through, you're going to have on the inside what he said you would have. And none of this would have happened, because you have to understand. Now, y'all know how y'all talk now. I wonder why they getting married so fast. Folk will count now. Didn't you say they got married in September? Folk will count on you now. Mary knew, my yada baba, that this is going to cost me something. If I say yes to God, I'm going to be immediately catapulted into the gossip column of Nazareth. Folk are not going to believe the miracle that just happened. But she said those great words, which has us sitting in here tonight today. She's told the angel, be it done unto me according to your word. She traded the life she would have had for the life that God would give her. And I don't want you to think it was easy. I know you see all these pictures and marriages look so whatever she looking. But there was always a cloud around Jesus. Because the townspeople knew that ain't Joel's boy. That's not Joseph's baby. Look at his nose. That, you know that ain't Joel. My soul says yes. And Joseph knew that it wasn't his. Imagine what that conversation was like. I'm moving on. After Jesus was born, Mary started having children that were directly hers and Joseph's. So we have a blended family. Now, say what you will to me. But blended families don't always work out like you would hope they would. Y'all might as well get off me because I know what I'm talking about. Sometimes folk will make you feel bad because you don't have the same mama and daddy. And we used to tell BB he was adopted. And he would just break out and go to cry. I don't know why he went for that every time. Let me just throw this in and I'm gonna cut across the field. I know there was a problem because his other brothers, James and them, they didn't believe Jesus was the Christ. You think it's wonderful to be the star of the family. You don't understand that everybody is pointing at you. Here we have Jesus. I got to close. 12 years old. He's in the temple. Astounding the scribes and the elders, asking questions, twisting them into knots, speaking with such authority as if he knew God. Stayed there for like 2 days. His parents had left him. And they searched the caravan and found that Jesus was not there. Turned around, came back 2 days later, and found him where they left him. He was in the temple. And just as a good measure, if you left God, you're going to have to come back and find him where you left him. Jesus was teaching, and they said, Jesus, your mother, your father, they're here. They can't get in. Jesus turned around and said, who is my mother? Who are my sisters and my brothers? Then he answered the question and said, he that doeth the will of my father. That's my mother. That's my brother. That's my sister. Jesus was 30 years old when he shows up on the shores of the Jordan. He's baptized of John. And all these years, that cloud had been hanging over. Who's his mama? Who's his daddy, rather? And then when he went down in the water and came up straightway, his father spoke. They thought he was dead, beaten, couldn't find him, but he spoke from the portals of heaven and said, this is my beloved son. I wish I had a happy church. I'm just about finished. In whom I am well pleased. Let me get to where we're going here. Jesus is hanging on the cross, dying. The next few verses, he's going to say, it's finished. That's how close he was to leaving here. But he stops, looks out in the foothills of Calvary, notices, as John writes and says, his mother, his auntie, Mary Magdalene, and he saw John, the one that loved Jesus. All the rest of them gone. Peter gone. Bartholomew, they gone. They split up. John followed him with the mothers. That's why it ain't bad to hang out with the mothers. I don't hear nobody talking to me. Somehow, those women had an affinity for Christ. Yes, sir. The Bible says in Matthew 27, said that many women followed him and ministered unto him. Mothers will not only follow you, but they'll do for you. They'll give you when you don't deserve to have it. Lord, have mercy. They're selfless. They work for you. I remember my mama taking on other jobs, doing different things, selling Tupperware, ordering stuff from Finger Hut. Y'all don't sit there and act like y'all don't know what Finger Hut is. Always doing something because she wanted us to have. Are you listening to me? They followed Jesus and they ministered of, the Bible says, of their substance. Jesus is hanging on the cross. He stops dying. And he looks at John the Revelator and says to Mary, woman. I told you, he never called her Mary. He never called her mama. He said, woman, behold thy son. And then he says to the disciple, behold your mother. The wonderful thing, and I'm finished. God will never use you and leave you to your own devices. He's saying so clearly to Mary, Mary, I interrupted your life around 13 to 15 years old. So if we calculate, Mary is in her late 40s and early 50s. She got a lot of living to do. She had some sons. But Jesus says the spiritual outweighs the natural. I'm not giving you to James. I'm not giving you to Joseph. I'm giving you to John. Because you gave me your youth, I'm going to take care of you. I got to close now. Saints used to sing a song, be not dismayed, whate'er betides, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you. Whatever you need, God will supply. God will take. See, you have a lot of people that feel like you're giving God too much. You only
13, you're only 14, you're only 15. You should live some. And then, no, if you give God your youth, God will give you a future. He stops dying, says, "Woman, you got a son now. You follow me as far as you can on the carnal side. But I'm going to take care of you." Looks at John and says, "John, take care of your mama. I don't understand how we drive nice cars, wear nice clothes, eat fine food, and our mama's struggling. No, sir, no, sir. I want to teach you something. If you want to be blessed, bless your mama. Hallelujah. I told my mama, you don't ever have to worry about nothing. And you may not understand the story of my mother, and I won't tell all her business, but let me say this. That her daddy was not very present in her life. Isn't that amazing? That your father not present and God give you 7 boys. Y'all better hear what I'm telling you. And she never disrespected her father. Matter of fact, we had his funeral right over there in the chapel. Because she loved her father. And even if your father hasn't been all of that or your mother hasn't been all of that, you still have the responsibility, watch, and the privilege to take care of her. It's a privilege. I said it's a privilege. Young man, it's a privilege to take care of your mother. God will honor that. As a matter of fact, it's the first commandment with promise. Jesus does a spiritual transfer, a spiritual transition. Right in the middle of dying, he transfers the deed of his mother to his beloved disciple. And the Bible says, from that hour, she went home with John. I don't have time to go through all of the questions, but it's amazing because she had more children. But she ends up with John. Because John is the spiritual son. And sometimes, I want you to understand, blood may be thicker than water, but if you've been born again, spirit overwhelms blood. Are you listening to me? Folk will take care of you till they get tired of you. And then they'll back them and say, "Well, you ain't really my mama." But when there's a spiritual transfer, then you got to do it, because you recognize that I was born again, not of flesh and blood, but of the water and of the spirit. I've been changed, because it's very possible that my blood family may not make it in. And I'm not following them to hell.
You can die without Jesus. You can die without the Holy Ghost if you want to. I'm going to come to your funeral. And I'm going to say bye. Because you won't see me no more. Because the only ones that are going to get up out of the grave are those that have been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Your eternal inheritance is in Jesus. Your eternal reward is in Jesus. Your eternal resting place is in Jesus. And so Jesus looks at the virgin, at the woman that was used to bring him into the world. And he does not leave her without first transferring her care into the hands of someone that loves him. I want you to know we have some great mothers. We have some great mothers. And I praise God. I don't know why I had no plan of mentioning it, but I, this past week, just started thinking on the mothers that I grew up with. You can stand, I'm finished. And how they have made such indelible impressions in my life and in my spiritual growth. There was a mother. She was tall, she was statuettes. Her name was Mother. I know Elder Hubbard, Noah, and a few others around here. Her name was Mother Pinckney. And Mother Pinckney was just a wonderful woman of God. She was a woman. Her husband had been the deacon in my great-grandfather's church for over 40 years. And I've told the story how she, in the 60s, contracted cancer. And Elder Winan came to church and told Deacon Pinckney, he said, "Brother Pinckney, I asked God to give Sister Pinckney back." And he was trying to just cope with the fact that his wife was dying. And he said, "Elder Winan, don't say that. Don't say that." He said, "Well, I asked God to bring her back." They had put her in the back room. They didn't have all of the chemos and all the different things. When you got to a certain age, but they didn't have hospice back then. They just put you away and waited for you to die. And they had put her in the back room. And Mother Pinckney was a praying woman. And as she lay in the bed, she said an angel came in the room. Lord, an angel came in the room and grabbed her by the hand and showed her how to get out of the bed. Lifted her up out of the Bakatiando Bosha. Lifted her up out of the bed. And Mother Pinckney came back. God healed her completely of cancer. She outlived Brother Pinckney. She outlived Elder Winan. And I was going up the stairs one time at 2135 Mac Avenue. I was in my teens. And she stopped me, and she was a soft-spoken woman. She said, "Your name is Marvin. Don't let them call you Peanut. You're Marvin." I said, "Thank you, Mother Pinckney." To have folk that can see who you are,
mothers. I took Brother Donnie and Nene and Cindy and I said, come on, I'm going to introduce y'all to a saint. And we went and found Mother Wells. Mother Wells was about 90-something years old. She was living by herself. We knocked on the door. She said, amen! Coming to the door, hallelujah! We opened up the door and she looked. I said, Mother Wells, how you know? She said, oh, amen, he's good. She was in the wheelchair. She rolled on back. She said, oh, I know you, I know you. She said, your mother, your father. And she went to talk and she looked at Nene and Cindy. She said, I know y'all, your mother, yes. She looked at Donnie and said, now I don't know you. Then she said, amen, but you're a preacher. Y'all better hear what I'm telling. I'm talking about mothers. Mother Wells, we started talking, and she said, oh, she said, your mother and father, they had twins. She said, and I would take them. I asked your mother, could I carry you? And I pushed you in the, she didn't say you, she said, I pushed them in the strollers. And I took them down from the church and I lifted them up. And I said, God, make them a preacher. And she went to speaking and to make them a preacher. I looked at her and I said, mother, I'm one of the twins. She said, amen! I'm telling you. To have those mothers, lift those hands all over the sanctuary. Father, we thank you. We thank you that you make a spiritual transfer. I praise you for it. And I pronounce your choicest blessings upon all the mothers that are here in this church, all of those that are watching by way of technology. I speak a blessing upon the mothers that you would cause them to know that they're not alone, that you will never leave them, that you will never forsake them, that Father, whatever, hallelujah, whatever they ask, you're going to make it happen. Do it for them, Lord. Heal our mothers. Heal them, extend their lives. I rebuke Alzheimer's. I rebuke dementia in the name of the Lord Jesus. Give them their memory back. Hallelujah. Let them enjoy their lives. And we give you praise in Jesus' name. If there's someone here that says, Pastor, I want to be saved. I want to give my life to the Lord. You can come now. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Anyone today? Woo! Come on and give him praise then. Father, we thank you for those that are watching by way of Facebook or social media, and I pray that they would know that you are a God that has no distance, that you would go right where they are, that you would touch their lives and change them forever. In Jesus' name, come on and give God a hand clap of praise. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord very expeditiously. We're going to receive our offering. I want everyone that can and will to sow a seed of $50. If you can't do that, do $100. I want everyone to give. If you need an envelope, raise your hand. Our youth ushers are ushering. Isn't this wonderful? We all tithe here at Perfecting Church. I'll never leave you. Never forsake you.
No matter what you're going through, I have good news for you. I'll be with you always. Yeah, na 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 na. No matter what. I'll never leave. Mothers, he'll never leave you. No matter, no matter, no matter. How to give is showing on your screen. In stormy weather.
In stormy weather.
It is my pleasure.
It is my pleasure.
I want to take care. Trust me, trust me.
Trust me.
What a promise, what a promise. We all tithe here at PC. I said we all tithe here at Perfecting Church. Everyone standing in the balcony on the main floor. I'll be with you. Lift that seed up, Father. We thank you for the opportunity to give. We stand amazed at your ability to take so little and do so much. Bless now both gift and giver according to their faithfulness, according to their cheerfulness. For it's not as the debt I owe, but as a seed I sow. Those of you that are here, move your offering to the end of the aisle. The person on the end, will you remain standing until the finance department comes and retrieves the seed today. Pleasure.
It is my pleasure.
I want to take care
of all your needs. Trust me and you'll be. I'll be with you.
So we have so many visitors. I thought they had it up on the screen. You can give by going to PC, $PC Detroit. Hallelujah. There it is, they got a new screen up. All right. Four ways to give. I'll be with you.
I'll be with you.
In stormy weather.
In stormy weather.
It is my pleasure.
It is my pleasure. I want to take care of all your needs.
Somebody would believe that. No matter how old you get, never,
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 can you say it one more time? Thank you.
what you need. I want to take care. Trust me. If there's someone here that says, hey, this is where the Lord would have me, and I want to join PC on this 2023 Mother's Day, you can come now. People, if you praise God, they will come. If you're watching out of state or at home and you want to join, all you have to do is email to membership@perfectingchurch.org. Is there someone in the building today that says, I want to join Perfecting Church? You can come now. People, give God praise. Hallelujah. Let me say, we have a beautiful rose, what is it called? Backdrop. And please take a picture. I think it's so nice. You can run out there and take one with your mother. Let's give God praise as we turn the service back into the hands of Elder Andre Heath.
Please give your attention to the announcements. Pastor, come. Amen. She wants to join.
The oil. Just a little slow. I'm gonna get the oil.
Hallelujah. 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 And what is your name, sweetheart?
Lena.
Lena who?
Lena.
Nina. Oh, that's a Spanish name. Nina, what's your last name?
Bailey.
Bailey. All right. I'm Pastor Marvin Winans. She said I know. This is Sister Janine Winans. Come on. Yeah. All right. You were a member before? And you left. But you want to come home, and we want you home. Father, we thank you for keeping her. We thank you for bringing her home. Bless Sister Nina now. Let the anointing that is upon this ministry rest upon her life. In Jesus' name. Come on, throw your arms around and welcome her to Perfection. Come on, throw your arms around the room. And they can follow them, sweetie. And we have some people here from Cleveland. Who's from Cleveland? Hi, Cleveland. Bless you. Let's give God praise for them. I was really pulling for the Cavaliers, but they didn't make it. But he said he's from Michigan. Hallelujah. God is good, isn't he? All right, all right. We back with Elder Heath.
Now, please give your attention to the announcements.
Good day, members and friends of Perfecting Church. It is time for the Perfecting News. Tuesdays are terrific at Perfecting. We begin with 6 a.m. prayer, followed by 11:15 a.m. and 7 p.m. pastoral Bible study. Come and grow in the Word. Our week continues with Holy Ghost class on Wednesday. We encourage you to come if you desire an initial filling or if you want to be renewed in your spirit. Come with expectation. Do you like to shop? Do you like finding great deals? If the answer is yes, mark your calendar for Saturday, June 24th, as the wonderful women of PC plan Shop Till You Drop, a one-day trip to Chicago to one of the best outlet malls with stores like Bloomingdale's, Tommy Hilfiger, Nordstrom's Rack, Calvin Klein, and the list goes on. Men, don't worry, you are welcome too. Go to the chapel immediately following today's service to secure your seat or call the church for more information. her children rise and call her blessed. Proverbs 31 and 28. Perfecting Church celebrates all amazing mothers. We pray you have been blessed during today's special service in honor of you. Mothers, we have one more gift for you. You and your family are invited to take pictures in front of the beautiful Mother's Day backdrop in the lobby. You will remember this day for years to come. Again, Happy Mother's Day. Holy Convocation 2023 kicks off next week. Clear your calendar. Attend during the day and the evening. You are not going to want to miss one moment.
Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you will revive me.
I will never forget your precepts, for by them you have revived me.
This is my comfort in my affliction, that your word has revived me.
Marvin L. Winans and Perfecting Fellowship International invites you to a life-changing conference that will repair your wounds, restore your faith, and revive your soul. Holy Convocation 2023. Revive Monday, May 22nd through Friday, May 26th in Detroit, Michigan. We will be revived in 5 days of powerful Hour of Power services with Pastors Ronnie Lee and Dion Lamont, and evening services featuring musical guests Maurice Yancey and One Accord, the Clark Sisters, and Caleb Carroll. And the ministry gifts of Bishop Kevin Wallace.
There is one reason I believe I know God is getting ready to use young people in this house and across this nation. It's because they are in the crosshairs of the enemy, and the devil is trying to destroy them and bring confusion to them and speak lies over them. It's a beast trying to attach to what God is about to use. But I feel like walking around and telling the devil, he is in trouble.
Valerie Daniels Carter.
That the word of the Lord has declared it, he has spoken it. It didn't seem like it was going to happen, but I'm standing on the promises. God.
Pastor Sully Malungu.
Too late, too late, too late, too late, too late, too late, too late. You should have done it before this service. Too late, because in this service I receive my healing. In this service I receive my promotion. In this service I receive my financial breakthrough. In this service I receive my contract.
This should be like Marvin L. Winans.
The same stone that they threw out and said he would never be anything, God made him the head of the corner. Everything that the church is standing on is because of Jesus. Share your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, it's all because of Jesus.
Pastor Mark Moore.
You don't always need to go through a whole lot of motion to get your prayer answered. You don't need to always get Bishop on the phone in order to get your prayer answered. But all you need is one word from the Lord.
And Pastor Donnie McClurkin.
How can I be happy in my storm? Well, because he's already prophesied that you've got to get to your destination. No wind, no rain, no wave, no thunder, no lightning can stop you from your destination. It might slow you up, but it can't stop your progress.
But wait, there's more. What will Holy Convocation be without the Singing Shepherds concert? Get your tickets now for the concert of the year. Showcasing the incredible talents of our PFI pastors, hosted by you-know-who, none other than B.B. Winans. We encourage everyone to register for Holy Convocation. Register today and receive
special recognition, a personalized convocation lanyard, exceptional discounts for purchases, entry to Holy Convocation daytime sessions,
and your tickets to the Singing Shepherds concert with PFI pastors
George Blanks, Daryl Blair, Reva Watkins, and Donnie McClurkin, and an unforgettable empowerment session featuring Dr. A.R. Bernard. Go to pfi.world for a complete schedule of worship services, events, and host hotels. Holy Convocation 2023, Monday, May 22nd through Friday, May 26th, in person in Detroit, Michigan, and streaming live. Get ready to be revived.
Praise God, praise God. Come on, let's give God praise. I want to say that we're over halfway there. We want at least 1,000 people to register for Holy Convocation. Registration is still open, and I want you to come. I sense that God is going to move in our Holy Convocation like he has never moved before. And I know you may say that. We say that every year, and he shows out every year. I've been talking to different pastors, and people are calling. I mean, it's just such anticipation. Just last week talking with Dr. A.R. Bernard and what he's going to bring to the table. You want to come. You don't want to limit what God is doing in your life. Or just, God didn't call you just to warm a seat. God didn't call you just to do, there are many things that God's going to revive in you in this convocation. So I want everyone to be praying, to be fasting as we move toward this convocation. Amen. And don't forget to register. Elder Healy.
Amen.